Will you please stand? I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
troubled hearts the light of hope, and strengthen in us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Clare's not going to speak of David's early life for us. Please sit.
Christmas was our favourite time of year. Why wouldn't it be with the children? It was fantastic. The anticipation, the family movies, the enormous tree, the music, but most of all, just being together. Each year, our dad's parents would come to visit Christmas, Montague and Doris. And one year, Mum said to Dad, "Do you know, I'd just like it to be just the five of us this year, you and I, the three children." And so it was decided. Christmas morning arrived and we all raced downstairs to open our presents. David, Spirograph, a Slinky, Etch-a-Sketch, and a Carmo Satin Punk. Me, Tiny Tears, a Toy Pram, a Tea Set, and Julie, Money, Perfume, Records, Clothes. Christmas telly was on in the background and our naughty sausage dog Benji was ripping up the discarded paper in the lounge. Mum was busy in the kitchen preparing dinner and David ran in and said, "I feel really sad today." And she said, "Why, it's Christmas Day, it's the best day of the year." And he said, "Because Nana and Grandad are on their own." So Mum went, "John, go pick your Mum and Dad up." So off he went, picked them up, and it was 7 for Christmas dinner, as usual. But that was David all over, wasn't it? Always thinking about other people. We were particularly close, mainly due to the age difference, there was less than 2 years between us. We walked to school together, we did our homework together, we played out together. And in the 70s, those were the days when it was okay to be out all day, as long as you stay together and come home before the street lights come on. All of those in my age will recognise that. We learned to play the piano together and we looked after each other, or shall I say, David was always looking after me. When I was about 10 and David was about 12, Mum and Dad bought a big old Victorian house with a shop at the front. Mum ran the shop and it sold ladies and children's clothes. Unbeknown to our parents, when the shop was closed, David and I used to sneak into the shop window and David used to like unscrewing the mannequin's hands and holding them as though they were his own. And we would stand very, very stunning on the window, different poses, until somebody walked past, or better still, stopped and looked in the window, and then we'd jump out and scare them. Needless to say, I'm surprised at this day that we didn't cause any heart attacks in our sleepy little village. Or that nobody, you know what you're saying, doctors in. Nobody went to the shop the next day and said, "Your 2 years children are terrorising the residents of Leicester." So we did this for months and months and months. As we grew up and developed our taste for music, we built a huge joint record collection and we joined going to loads of concerts, Depeche Mode, Yazoo, Thompson Twins, Duran Duran, Culture Club, Taste for Fears, too many to mention really. When I was in fourth form, David was in the lower sixth, and this gave myself and my best friend Christina, who's with us today, so much street cred because we hung out with Dave and his older mates. All the parties, all the cider drinking, all the smoking, all the explaining. Christina credits David for introducing her to all her boyfriends at this time and for educating her in all matters of room. She's wearing her special necklace today in honor of that fact. We shared other passions like cooking and we'd often chat on the phone of cooking ideas or recipes for upcoming dinner parties. He had a wicked sense of humour. when he came home the last time, just a few weeks ago. The four of us, myself, Paul, Julie and Dave, played the music game, guessed the intro. I didn't recognise all the tracks, and Dave smiled and said, "Oh, this one reminds me of you." "Oh, that is so lovely, what is it?" "It's Mardi Bum by the Arctic Monkeys." It strikes me, looking back, that David was always happy, despite the setbacks and traumas he encountered in his life. The love of so many people contributed to all this happiness, I'm sure. His family, his friends, his work colleagues, and of course the love of his life, Paul, and their wonderful son, Harrison. And this reminds me of a quote by Henry David Thoreau. He believed that happiness is like a butterfly. The more you chase it, the more it will elude you. But if you turn your attention to other things, it will come and sit softly on your shoulder. David never had to chase happiness, and that butterfly sat softly on his shoulder for 55 years. A limb has fallen from my tree. I keep hearing the voice that says, "Grieve not for me. Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I lived while I was still strong. Continue my heritage, I'm counting on you. Keep smiling and surely the sun will shine through. My mind is at ease and my soul is at rest, remembering all how I truly was blessed. Continue traditions, no matter how small. Go on with your lives, don't worry about walls. I miss you all dearly, so keep up your chin until the day comes and we're all together."
Very honoured to be reading for Dave, because I think we've all been blessed love from me. This is the gift of love. It's 1 Corinthians 13, verse 1 to 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect. But when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. And when I became a person, I gave up my childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. So, faith, hope, love, abide these three. But the greatest of these is love.
I'm here to speak about David's service in the Metropolitan Police. He joined almost exactly 18 years ago on the 26th of October 2003. Initially, David was posted to Woodbury after the movement to Blackheath before he arranged for a transfer to Nambeth Borough. David worked for Bristol and Kent police stations. David started to pick his career off in uniform and then into various units with the CID. These included the Case Suppression Unit, Beat Crimes Unit, Burglary Squad, Community Safety Unit, and also assigned as a field intelligence officer. I first met David when I was posted to Bristol Police Station in 2010. I was working in the custody suite and see David daily when dealing with detainees. I was immediately struck by his professional, calm, and pleasant manner. Nothing appeared to faze him. The first day I met David, I bonded with him. We were the same age, David's always keen to tell everyone in the police station his latest plans to make it bigger and more entertaining for all. After a long time, David Paul began to be on Britain's Got Talent. Did we all know about that?
Get ready for me, love, 'cause I'm a comer. I somewhere.